The Southern Alberta Art Gallery welcomes you to Anton Ginzburg's Blue Flame, Constructions and Initiatives. As a New York-based and Russian-born artist, Ginzburg uses an array of historical and cultural references as avenues or access points to investigate and reflect on the ways in which our past lingers in the present, just slightly out of focus. This exhibition brings Ginzburg face-to-face with the collapsed relics of a modernist or universalist project in ruins. Investigating the Futema school of art, which cultivated suprematism and constructivism, Ginzburg pierces the ideological core of this modernist project while remaining removed enough to highlight the defective approaches formative to this type of universalist thinking. The works you'll see are a direct engagement with constructivist pedagogical experiments and Ginzburg's own mythologies. During the duration of his residency at the Gushall in the Crow's Nest Pass, Ginzburg engaged in a one-month self-taught course where he further enmeshed himself in the pedagogical practice of the Fukudemas, reanimating the avant-garde methodologies into the present-day North American context. Looking to meld progressive politics and technological innovation into the fabric of their society, the school looked to the materials used to construct and design the world around them. Ginzburg takes a slightly iconoclastic reading of this culture, focusing less on the specific creators, but instead on embedding himself into the network of discourse which helped buttress the movement. In this way, he touches more so on the formative aspects of their intellectual and material actions. As a cultural relic, the teachings of the Futemas play a role in shaping the thoughts of contemporary arts, yet little attention is paid to the flaws which eventually led to its ruin. A misinterpretation or a misreading of these foundational ideologies may lead to a distorted perspective or romanticizing of the movement. This historical bias is led back to historicism's false singularity and a false sense of distance from the past. With this exhibition, Ginzburg reminds us to approach historical influences and history itself as an entangled and knotted phenomenon. By incorporating the teaching of the school into his present work, Ginzburg is acknowledging his role in both awareness-raising and in mediating the history that he studies. Because of this, there is a sense of tension in his work. On one hand, there's a story of a somewhat silenced and forgotten school, and on the other, a historical project that he's nationally tied to. As you walk through the gallery, ask yourself what sorts of universalist notions were lost as our culture shifted to postmodernity, or ask yourself which have never come to full fruition. What types of hopeful modernist ideals never actually had a chance to be explored? Are there avenues to take as we navigate these cultural ruins that could resurrect the optimism and potential that these ideas originally carried? How does Ginzburg resist against seeing history as just a chain of events or a progression, and instead chooses to see it as maybe one big mess or a catastrophe, if you will? By choosing to view history this way, what is Ginzburg articulating about the present? By using art's capacity to penetrate layers of the past and reflect upon the contemporary experience, Ginzburg sheds a critical light on our perception of history, culture, and the solidification of time.